Hi, and welcome to Foolicious Reviews, a channel where we talk about all things beauty that includes makeup, skincare, and sometimes hair care and nails. So if you're interested in any of those, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post, which is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Today we're discussing the Kaluli Classic 4L Mini Fridge and how I've been using it and what my thoughts are on this product, as well as whether you should invest in this product or not. So you can jump straight ahead to the review portion if you want to at this time. If not, then keep watching. So the brand has actually a lot of mini fridges with different capacities. The one I have is called Classic 4L, which means it can hold up to 4 liters, or it can store up to 6 of 12-ounce cans. This was actually a gift from my sister-in-law and my brother. I was super excited to receive it because I always wanted one, but I never bought one because I thought that would be frivolous spending, but I really wanted one. And I do have a mini fridge in my media room where I do store all of my snacks and stuff. So that is what I used to use prior to using this mini fridge. So I used to store things like a sleeping mask, like the Dr. Brandt Hydrobiotic sleeping mask. I love that, and it's so nice to apply when it's cooled up, as well as a facial roller. I use the Mint Para Beauty Rose Quartz facial roller, and I still use that. So. But the problem with that mini fridge was that it had food in it, so sometimes my products would smell like food, or sometimes the compartments won't really hold up the skincare stuff properly, and sometimes the fridge would be a little too cold for my skincare stuff. So sometimes, like, I think I had a mask that was in a sachet, and I put it in the fridge, and it kind of congealed a bit. So it made kind of sense for me to be using a skin fridge or a mini fridge. However, not everybody loves putting things in their fridge, like their skincare and stuff. But if you do, then you might want to check out a skin fridge or a mini fridge for those purposes. So I'm going to be showing you how I've been using it, what things I store in it, to kind of give you an idea of how much this product, this fridge in particular can hold of your skincare items. So over here, I have the Mint Para Beauty facial roller over here. It's in this bag. And I also have the Inkeyless Succinic Acid Acne Treatment over here. And I have already asked the brands if it's okay to store these in the fridge, and they said yes. So what I have here is the Haru Haru Wonder Black Rice Hyaluronic Acid Toner. I really like that, and a review of this will be up really, really soon. And then I have the 111 Skin Rose Gold Sheet Mask. It's a hydrogel mask that's really hyped up for some reason. And I bought like 5 of them, and I will be reviewing them really soon. So. And then I have the Bhatia Peptide Youth Restore Firming Body Serum. So Bhatia recently came out with their body care line, and the body serum was the product that I was most interested in from that line. So that's why I picked this one up, and I will be reviewing it in a few weeks. And then I have the Summer Friday Summer Skin Nourishing Body Lotion. This is also a new product from Summer Fridays. A lot of brands are actually launching their body care items, like Glow Recipe, Summer Fridays, Bhatia. So I think we'll be seeing a lot more of body care stuff. So I picked up one the body lotion from Summer Fridays, as well as this from Glow Recipe. This is not the full size, obviously. This is a deluxe sample. It's the Watermelon Glow Pink Dream Body Cream. This is their version of a body lotion. And then I have the Fresh Rose Deep Hydration Face Cream. This is like a very tiny size. And I absolutely love this face cream. And it feels really nice when it's cooled as well. And then I have the COSRX Hydrium Watery Toner. This is a hyaluronic acid toner, a hydrating toner from COSRX. I haven't started using this, but I'm just storing it in my fridge. And I'm going to start using it right when I'm finished with the Haru Haru toner. And I have 2 full sizes of Elemis Plumping Pillow Facial Sleeping Masks. I love these. Both of these are new. The one I'm currently using is in my nightstand. And I have like stocked up 2 of these because I love them that much. And then I have my favorite vitamin C serum from Pacifica Beauty. It's the CNC Love Vitamin Serum. If you've been following me for a while, you must have heard me talk about this product. Both of these are new, and the one I'm currently using, it's in my nightstand. I keep those things in my nightstand because I like having I like having my skincare at hand. That way I have no excuse. So that was basically everything that I have in my skincare fridge. And so the purpose of me showing you what things I have in my fridge is to kind of like give you an idea as to how much this 4L can store. I think this is the smallest size they have. They do have 10L, 15L, and then I think 20 is their biggest. So I'm just reviewing this one because this is the only one that I've been using, and I'm not passing any judgment onto the others. So now that I've showed you how much it can store and how it looks, so now I can kind of like go in with the review portion of this, and I'm going to start off with my likes first. First off is the fact that you can use it with an outlet like I have right now, or in a car charger or a battery. The point is that it makes it more versatile in terms of using and charging it and turning it on. It has a fan in the back. It doesn't really have like a grill kind of thing that we have on regular fridges. So it's not going to be as noisy, and it's not going to emit that much heat. It's just a fan in the back. So it does need like a couple inches of distance between the wall and itself, if that makes sense. I also like that it comes in a lot of different colors and styles, as well as sizes. So if you don't like this color, you can definitely get a different color or a pattern. And they have a lot of collabs with different brands as well, like Coca-Cola and Evian and stuff like that. So if you want different patterns, you can definitely go on to their website and check them out. Also love how portable it is. This is kind of the handle portion, so you can just pick it up like this and pick it wherever you want. Since it's that small, you can definitely take it with you on travels, definitely not on an airplane, but you can pack it up in your suitcase, or you can have it in your car while you're on your road trip or something. It can be used in a variety of different ways. So like, I've been using it to store my skincare. You can use it to store your food and drink, or your medication, or breast milk, or you know, basically anything that you need to refrigerate. Despite being a fridge, it's very, very silent. I mean, you do hear like a tiny bit of the fan running, but it's not loud at all. It's actually, you know, like, it's kind of like a murmur, if that makes sense. So I know when we look at this, we immediately go, our thought immediately goes to it being a cooler or a fridge, but it can also be a warmer. So if you have medication or food that needs to be kept warm, then, or breast milk or whatever that needs to be kept warm, it can definitely do that. There's a switch in the back that has cool and then warm and then off, so you can just switch it to warm whenever you want, whenever you need to, and it can warm as well as cool, not at the same time, but it can do the job. Bear in mind that it's a warmer, not a microwave, so you cannot expect cold food to get like hot in there. You can only expect like hot food to stay warm in there, if that makes sense. As far as cooling goes, it can cool below, it can cool 30 degrees below ambient temperature. So that means that if you are keeping it in a room that's like 70 degrees, it can cool down to 40 degrees, so like 30 degrees lesser than that. So if you don't want it to be too cool, you have to make sure that you're not storing it in a room that is particularly the coldest. But having said that, it won't get too cold, if that makes sense, because I store it in my bathroom. That's where my whole vanity is, and that's my bathroom is like the coldest place in my house, and it can get really cold in there. But despite that, I don't think that this has got too cold, if that makes sense. It is like a normal cooling temperature, but not cold temperature, if that makes sense. I also like that there is removable shelving in there. You can see over here that there are marks. That's because that's the space for shelving, so you can remove that as well. This holder over here, that's also removable, so you know, you can customize it according to your preference. I have removed the shelving because I have products that are taller, so they need more space. And as you can see, it can fit a lot of products. I have like maybe 12 or 13 products in there, and this is the smallest size that they have. So if your needs are like bigger than mine, like if you have like a lot of skincare stuff to put in, or a lot of food stuff that needs to be stored, then you can definitely bump up a size. But I feel like this is a good size for a portable kind of fridge. So now that I've gone through my likes for this product, let's talk about my dislikes about this product. So first off, what I dislike is that it lacks a bit of finishing, because I'm being very picky, but the edges over here are not like symmetrical. It's not uniform. I can feel like this is a bit more raised over here than over here. So it lacks a little bit of finishing. I'm not saying that it's poorly made. It's not, but it lacks a little bit of like kind of like luxurious touch, if you know what I mean. But I also don't like about this model, not like all of them, because it doesn't apply to all of them, it just applies to this one, is the fact that you cannot set your temperature. So you cannot set what temperature you want it to be. So you have to rely on what the ambient temperature is and then go by that. So you have to be careful of how the ambient temperature is, and then expect that the cooling to be down to 30 degrees below it. So, you know, it would have been easier, obviously, for it there to be a thermostat in there or some kind of other settings. There is something like that in other models, more expensive ones. I think maybe 15L has it or something. So they do have it, but not at this price and not in this model. I also am not crazy about the fact that even though there is like removable shelving, the shelving itself is not adjustable. So you can only take out or put in the shelving. You cannot adjust what height you want. So the shelf can only be over here. It cannot be like higher than that or lower than that. But I guess that makes sense because it is already a small size. It's not practical enough, I guess, to have like an adjustable kind of shelving. So I do understand why they don't have it, but I also think that they should have included that option to make it more customizable for the user. And then the fourth thing, which I think is kind of my fault, is the fact that I've noticed just once, that ice kind of forms on the very back of this fridge. So like inside, but like at the very back, I can see like there's some kind of ice buildup where the screws are. And I think that's my fault, because they do warn about not overstuffing it. And I think maybe I might have overstuffed it before, not right now, but before this. I think I had more products in there, but I had to take a few of them out. And then afterwards, I haven't been experiencing that problem. So make sure that you're not overstuffing your fridge. Make sure that the door shuts all the way through, leaving it slightly open or something, and that you have this distance that we talked about. It needs 2 inches of distance between any wall and itself. So do that and you should be fine. After I've removed a few of the items that I had stuffed in, I didn't see any icing or anything else for that matter. So if you're interested in this model, in this product, you can find it on their website as well as on Amazon for $50. I feel like this is a good price for a fridge that has this kind of portability and these kind of features in it. You're definitely paying for the portability and the, you know, multifunctional use more than you're paying for like a fridge, because, you know, if that makes sense. So I do think that this is definitely worth its price. But will I recommend this to everybody? Probably not, because not everybody enjoys putting skincare or stuff like that in their fridge. But if you do use your main fridge to store some of your skincare items, but you're having kind of like trouble with it, then I suggest you look into this. This is going to be a really good swap for you. It's going to be more convenient, definitely. Like I said, it has like a lot of different uses, not just skincare, other stuff too. I think my husband really likes it too. He said he's going to get one for his car, a little bigger, so he can store his food while he's on the go. So again, it can be used for a variety of different things, variety of different ways. if your needs kind of fall into that category, in any of these categories like portability, I would definitely recommend this product to you. If not, then it's not something that you need to buy to maintain your skincare routine. I will not be repurchasing this one because I already have it, but I will be purchasing a bigger size, but not for the same reason, for a different reason. So now let's go in with my rating breakdown. And the first thing is performance. I'm gonna give it a whole point because you can use it in so many different ways. It can store so many things. It's a warmer, it's a cooler. There's like so much about it. It has got a lot going on with itself. And then there's price, which I'm also gonna give a whole point on, because I do definitely think that $50 is a reasonable price for a fridge with this kind of capacity, a fridge with this kind of portability, and these kind of conveniences. And that brings us to number three, longevity and convenience. I'm gonna give it a 0.75 over here, just because I would like more options with like setting your temperature as well as, you know, customizing your shelving. So I would like a little bit more of options there, but even without those options, this is a really good buy. And then there's recommendation and repurchase, which I'm going to give a 0.75 on, because again, not everybody needs it. So I'm not going to be recommended to everybody, because I'm not going to be like, you need to have this or else your life is over. No, it isn't. According to your needs, if you think you need it, then I would suggest this one for you. If you don't use these things, then definitely skip on it. Then there is special features, which I'm going to give a 0.75 on again, because I think it's really cool. I do think that it lacks a bit of finishing, which is why I'm not giving it a whole point on special features, but overall, it's a really good product. So that brings my total Foolicious score to a 4.25 out of a 5. And to be honest, I didn't think that I would like the skin fridge so much when my sister-in-law and my brother gave it to me. I was thinking to myself, do I really have the need for this? And even though I didn't really need it, I did want it. And now that I have it, I have been using it so much. And I have to say, it's such a nice feeling when I take my toner out and it's cooled. It's so refreshing. It's not something that you need, again, it's not something that you need, but it's that kind, it just makes the whole experience a bit, you know, more luxurious, if that makes sense. So that's my final word on that. Anyway, so that is it for me today. Thank you so much for watching and hanging out with me. Stay tuned for my next video, where I'm going to review the Haru Haru toner that we saw right now, or stick around and watch one of my older videos.